or something like that. We barely got by him last year. And this year, you know, we saw him a few times in the summertime, and, you know, they did real well. Their coach did real well. And they came out playing. They came out, and they just rammed it down our throat. It was like, oh, man, this could be a game here. And our kids just kept battling back, and finally then we kind of took control of the second half because we were down 14-0 or 14-10 at half. And then the second half, we started playing the game we're supposed to play, and we got a couple turnovers, and that kind of helped seal the deal for us. It was real nice, and, you know, they got a kind of a long run. They got like a 25-yard run. They got a fumble. We recovered it. We get it all the way down, you know. We end up throwing an interception in the end zone. Well, like the very next play, they throw an interception, and our backup quarterback, who was also playing defensive end for us, Nate Temple's little brother, Drew Temple, picked it off for a pick six, so which is really nice.
Wow.
Yeah. So Nate Temple threw a couple touchdowns, and his little brother intercepted, got a pick six for a touchdown. And that kind of pretty much sealed the deal. That put us at 31-14, and it was over there. It's been fun. You know, they're good kids, and they're fun to coach. You know, Nate's older, and stuff, and you know, he's playing quarterback, and you know, Drew's kind of taking it. He goes, I'll be defensive end. I'm okay. I'll be back in quarterback and stuff. And he's ready to step in if something happens, and he's off in playing defense, and it's been a really good thing.
So it sounds like the line's been holding up real well too on the offensive side. And then how about your backs back there? Mutah doing anything big?
He was 19 of 85 for one touchdown.
Boy, that's all you can ask for. You got a pretty good balance.
Yeah, oh, very much so. Yeah, we run a throw pretty close to 50-50. It's, you know, it's one way or the other. It's not by very much, that's for sure.
Next opponent.
We have Mar Vista at home next week. I don't know how they did. They traveled today, so I don't know what they've done. And I believe last week, I think they won. I don't remember off the top of my head.
Yeah, I believe they did.
But you know, Mar Vista, we've had good battles over the years, and I expect another good battle this week.
And
regardless of who has either more or less talent on the team, it's just a battle. It's usually you know, I'm hoping the tradition kind of stays, although last year we broke it. Home team's been, you know, winning, but last year it was reversed. The home team's both lost last year, so I'm hoping the home team comes back and wins, so that's us. Yeah, the grass is a different beast now. If you're playing grass, you have I think there's a little advantage there because, you know, depending on how thick it is or how it's worn, and, you know, then it's how moisture sits on it versus the artificial stuff is different, you know, because it sits there longer. It seems like it's just different now. I mean, me, I would love to be on grass every game if we could have nice grass.
Right.
I'd understand that, you know, life sometimes you got to have turf for everybody, but yeah, I would love to be back on grass every day.
And
grass does give you a little bit of advantage because I think there's only a couple schools left in the county that have grass. Mar Vista's one. I think Southwest San Diego's one, and of course Nate Brooks Mutah and Randy Smith had good games. DeWitt Sadler had a good game defensively. He made a couple good stops. We had Michael Victor had had a good game offensive defense. Jared Forrester had a good game. Drew Temple came in, like I said, and played defensive end, did a good job, got the interception, pick six.
Yeah, that Jared Forrester, man, I got to tell you, between you and me, that I think that is one of those kids that he's underrated and overlooked.
Oh, very much so. Yeah, because you sit and look at him and go, he's a football player? He's not real big. And you go, okay, but man, he's a competitor. He's one of those guys that's got heart. And he makes plays.
Yeah.
And our kicker did a great job. You know, he was perfect on extra points. His field goals, made one field goal. And he's kicking him in the end zone. Can't ask for better than that, kicking him in the end zone. I think he was short twice. Out of all of them, he kicked less in the end zone. So, and it seems like the first one or maybe two, don't make an end zone. But all the kicks after that, even though he's getting a little more tired of the game, the kicks start to get further and further. So, it was, yeah. So he had a nice game. So we had a lot of kids that came out and played.